Okay, so the first one I wanted to talk about was generative music. I wanted to see how generative you could get with, let's say, one Crave for now. Okay, so to start this off, I'm gonna make sure that there's no pattern in there, and we've just got a standard sound with no modulation. We've got a straight square there. Okay, so next what you want to do is put in a sequence. Just keep it all the same note. And we're going to make it five steps. Okay, that'll do. Right, the next thing we want to do is we want to send random assign. So to do that, hold rest, shift, and eight. Then from there, you want to go into the second page, which is yellow now, first page, second page, and you want to press 8. Press those two again, press 8 to come out the menu. Right, now we know that that's on random assign, so we're going to patch it to a mult. Always good to patch it to a mult. Then I'm going to patch the mult first to cut off, and just listen to it. Let's take it off 5. Okay. So you're just hearing random notes at the moment. Random steps. It's all the same note. Now we're going to patch it. Instead of patching it straight to the notes, which would give us this, I'm going to patch it to a mixer. That way we can choose the range of notes that it plays with. Oh, I unplugged the wrong thing in, I think. I've got my malt into the mixer. I've come out the mixer. There we go. So to start that again, I've gone assign into a mult, one mult into the cutoff, another mult into mix 2, and from mix CV there, you would go into oscillator CV. So now, as well as having random steps playing, or the gate opening randomly, I've now got random notes. So now I'll slow this down a little bit.
And we'll add some reverb.
Didn't really take much to get something quite interesting. Now there's many things we could do from here. One thing I like to do is get the LFO, get it to control the filter just a little bit. Need it on triangle. Oh, NTS1 went to sleep. One second. There we go. Really nice. can add a bit of glide to some of the steps as well, that would help. There's no point trying to change the notes because you wouldn't know what they are, but so just make sure glide is on that, turn it off, and we'll have a little bit. Now remember, you might not always hear it as well because the step might not play. To put it on more steps. That's a really good way of getting generative music out of it. You never know what it's going to do, but you can control it in a nice manner. So let's reset that pattern.
Let's turn the reverb off.
Don't need it anymore. Okay, so the next one was just a really simple one. Just combining two oscillators on it. Or giving the impression you've got two. So really for this, all you need to do is send the square LFO into the audio in and tune it. Let's turn the load up. Own. Now, because it's a short note, you don't hear the detuning so much when as it goes further on. And I have a feeling a lot of old synths work the same. That's why you've got a lot of short stab patches, because they didn't go out of tune over the length of time. Okay. Next one is ramp LFO. So let's just go back onto a normal tone, make sure nothing's being modulated. Okay, nice and normal. Okay, so this is really simple. You just plug the square into the LFO rate. Just make sure it's on triangle. Cut off down. And what have we got? Was it triangle into square? Something's not right. Oh, there we go. LFO needs to be on. So let's go square into triangle. And there's your ramp. Really underestimated. I use the ramp all the time. Can do it the other way around, you can get the triangle to modulate the square. That's more of a pulse. But that's almost a summing up patch near enough every time I use the LFO. haven't experimented with FMing with a pulse like that either, or a ramp. Sorry. So that could be something else to experiment with. Okay, so the next one is separating the filter envelope from the amp envelope. This is something that really winds me up. I don't like having them tied together with the same envelope. I like them to be separate. So I'd have a separate filter envelope and a separate amplifier envelope. I'll show you why that's really good, and I'll show you how I kind of get around it. But I mean, I use two Craves to do this, so maybe there'd be something better suited. But again, if we go back to normal, just make sure there's no modulations. That'll do for now. No, make that normal. Okay, cool. Yeah, so what you want to do is you want to go from the gate out of here into the gate envelope of the second one. And then you want to go from the gate into the second one into the cutoff. Sorry, the envelope of the second one into the cutoff. So now these are separate. This is my amp and has nothing to do with filter. However, this one, gate into thing, yep. This one should control my filter. There we go. So, if you pull the cutoff down on the first one, you'll notice that's just sustain. But on here, now we've got control of the filter separately. We pull this down, this is why this is good. I want the sound to sustain, but I don't want any sustain on the filter. I just want a little stab. Keeps it really clean and lets it ring out at the same time. Okay, so that's that one. And the last one was off notes with FM. So normally when you do FM, you tune it. But one thing I've picked up on is the idea of stop trying to hide stuff and just trying to make it shine a bit better. So if we put the triangle into FM, play a higher note so you can hear it better. Something like that. So the first note works. That's actually a bad example. It sounds good all the way through. Something like that would probably be better. So you can hear that some of them sound atonal. So let's just pick the ones that sound good. So one sounds good. Five sounds good. It's normally the case of FM. One, five, and eight. And 4.5. So we go 1, 4.5, 5, and 8. Really strong sequence. So now if we went from here, because this is quite basic at the moment, but if we went from a sine and we took it into the cutoff now,
try sticking some reverb on it.
Hear a little click in here, and that's because it's the random assign is being run straight into the cutoff. So we just run it through a mixer. Choose a point where we want it, like the lowest. Add a little bit of modulation. The reason that works is because the notes tend to tie with each other with FM. So 1, 5, and 8 are normally going to work. 4 I found works quite a lot, but it depends on what you pick. It's definitely a good thing to muck around with. All right, guys, so that's my second video for the Behringer Craves. I hope someone learned something. Hope it was useful to someone at least. Thanks for your time. Like and subscribe.